Please subscribe for more videos and remember to hit the notification bell so you never miss a new video. Are you tired right now? I want you to listen to this video when it's time to go to bed. Because what I'll do is walk you through all the steps that you need to get ready for bed and have a quite calming nighttime routine so that as you get ready, you're actually able to get sleepier and sleepier, letting yourself get as sleepy as possible. First, we're just gonna do a quick check-in wherever you are. Maybe you're hanging out on the couch, or you just finished eating, or you just read a book. Maybe you just put down your phone after checking some emails or scrolling through social media. So right now in this moment, I want you to just temporarily, for just a few seconds, take a pause and put all of that aside and really check in with yourself and see, okay, if it were dark in this room and there were no screens on, or maybe just a screen distantly in the background, and if you were nice and comfy in a bed, would you like to fall asleep and get tons of quality sleep tonight? And if the answer is yes or maybe, then let's move forward and help you get totally ready for bed so that you can get that restful sleep. I want to remind you that it's really important for so many areas of your health to get at least 7 hours of good quality sleep throughout the night. Even if that means that maybe for 30 minutes or a few minutes you have to get up and go to the bathroom or something, that's okay as long as you can get back to sleep and get a few more hours. Ideally, we actually want to get 8 to 10 hours, but I know sometimes that's not possible for your schedule, right? And that's okay. We'll just try our best and just try again each day as we go. So, what I want you to do first, as you sit here, we haven't moved anywhere, gone anywhere just yet, is first look around the room and see if there's any lights that you can turn off. And we want to just have the dimmest light possible, or the fewest light sources possible as we get ready for bed. So maybe that means turning off a few of the bedroom lights, or just the lights in whatever room that you're in right now. And what we're gonna do is turn off a bunch of these lights. As we've gotten up to do that, we're also going to take a look around and see, okay, are there any dishes that need to go to the dishwasher? Because one thing that you can do to start yourself up tomorrow morning for success is to have some clean dishes available, or at least have the used dishes where they should be for whenever they need to get cleaned. So if you're super tired, that might just mean moving the dishes over near the sink or the dishwasher, and maybe just leaving them there for tomorrow morning or sometime tomorrow, where you can put them in the dishwasher or wash them. But we're just gonna take it slow and just check that off our list. So as you look around, just see if there's any dishes you can bring back to that area, and whether you take care of that tonight, of putting them away into the dishwasher, or perhaps hand washing them. That is up to you and some lights, and we've only set the lights that are on to a dim setting, or we've maybe just turned on a simple night light. Now we're gonna head to the bathroom and do our nighttime routine. So, first thing, sea salt into the water if you need to nourish is like 1 to 2 feet long, and you're going to wrap one end around your index finger, secure that with your thumb, and then you'll start on that end with the floss. And I like to start between my two front teeth, then work my way over to the left, going between each tooth and just gently massaging the floss up and down slightly, then kind of pulling it through gently to again just dislodge any food that's there. And I just go tooth by tooth until I get to the back left tooth. And that one for me is particularly intense. I'll even do that one a couple times to get everything out. Then I continue to the right side of my top teeth and I go just tooth by tooth between each space one at a time. And each time I move on to a new tooth, I wrap a little bit more of the used floss around my finger and I have more clean floss that I use on the next tooth in between. And then I go down to the lower teeth and I start in the middle. And again, I go over to the left and I get them bit by bit. And then I go over to the right from the center. And again, I have a little space between two of my teeth that just seems to always get stuck there. So I give that space some extra attention. And then I continue on and on till I get to the back of my bottom right teeth. And so you may have spaces like that that need a little bit extra attention. So I want you to take the time to do that. And you may have spaces that are a little bit more sensitive. So I want you to not rush this so you can take good care of yourself and not cause any bleeding or discomfort. And once you've completed your flossing, just go ahead and discard that into the trash. We're going to go back now to another hot water rinse to get anything out that the flossing has just dislodged. So we're just going to do a swish again with either the hot water or the hot salt water. Or now at this point you could do mouthwash as well. And you're just going to put whatever amount in your mouth is comfortable and then just swish, swish, swish for maybe 10 or 15 seconds. And once you're done, then just let that go into the sink. And now you should be clear mostly of most food particles. So we're going to switch to brushing. And I really like to use a Quip toothbrush because it measures the amount of time that you need to brush. Gives little vibrations when it's time to switch to a different part of the mouth. And I like to use specifically the super soft bristled brush that comes with the Quip as an optional order because I really need that super soft bristle for my gum health. And I think honestly most people do, so that could be something to consider in the future. For my toothpaste, I always like to use the Boca brand of toothpaste because it has nanohydroxyapatite in it as opposed to fluoride. And nanohydroxyapatite, or just hydroxyapatite, is very effective and it's like the gold standard for dental healthcare, especially like over in Japan. They've used it safely for many, many years. And so it's very good for your enamel and for sensitivity. And so I love to use that because I found that it has really reduced sensitivity. And it is just so refreshing to use to know that it really is helping out my dental health and enamel. So I'll put it like a pea-sized amount on the Quip toothbrush and just begin to brush my teeth. Again, just letting it go for about 2 minutes. And while I'm brushing my teeth, it's at that point when I just will honestly either stand there and just simply breathe. Hopefully at this point I've just switched to only like a nightlight in the bathroom so that my eyes can adjust to the darker light and it's not quite so bright. This is really, really important to allow your brain to get more melatonin and for it to get into sleep mode. Supplements can be girl's general health, so it could be something to maybe consider. The two supplements that I really do recommend is magnesium glycinate and vitamin D3K2. Vitamin D3K2 is very helpful for your oral health and your mental health as well, especially in the winter in either the northern or southern hemispheres, depending when your winter is. We just really can't get enough sunlight to make the levels of vitamin D that our body needs naturally. So supplementing with a simple vitamin D supplement is incredibly helpful. And if you're someone who wants to reduce the number of pills and capsules that you swallow, I really like to use a vitamin D dropper that has organic olive oil as the carrier method for the vitamin D3K2. So I'll usually start with that first, and I'll just apply 5 drops underneath my tongue with the dropper that comes with it. And then as that kind of soaks in under my tongue, I'll then move on to my last remaining supplements. And as I swallow each one with a nice gulp of water, that gulp of water is also helping to carry down the olive oil with vitamin D3K2 that I've just swallowed as well. So that order has a specific purpose to help me just take everything in at once. And I also have a little bit of trouble sometimes with taking pills and capsules, so what I will do is be sure to go nice and slow, and I'll just go one at a time. And with each one at a time, I will take a nice, big, huge sip of water, and I'll let the pill go to the back of my tongue or the capsule, and then with a huge sip of water, I'll just slowly and gently focus on swallowing just the water, and the pill or the capsule will go down along with it. So I like to try and do each night 4 magnesium glycinate capsules to get around 400 milligrams of it. That's really helpful for gentle muscle relaxation. It also aids in muscle recovery post-workout. It acts as a really gentle and mild sleep aid. It helps with cortisol management and regulation, which is a stress hormone. And it just is also very helpful for your digestion in terms of regulating digestion. And to be perfectly honest, I find it even more effective than taking probiotics at helping to regulate digestion in a super gentle way. It is not causing indigestion like something like a laxative, like magnesium citrate would do. But it's just a very, very gentle method of just simply softening things and helping to promote those daily bowel movements, which are so important for your overall health and for hormone balancing as well. So just a really simple thing to include, and has many benefits for anyone, honestly, whether male or female or different ages. It's a great supplement to consider including. Now me, because I'm also anemic, or I at least have low iron sometimes, I'll also take some iron glycinate every other night. So I'll take a few of those capsules. And the iron glycinate is really important for blood cell production. And I really, really notice a difference when I do not take it. So it's important to me to take it regularly. Back in 2020, I was so low on my iron that I literally felt exhausted constantly, and I almost felt like I could just lay down and fall asleep at any point, which was actually pretty dangerous. So I got tested and I realized that I did need to supplement with it. So all of my supplements that I take, they have a basis because there's something that I've been tested for. And I don't like to just take extra supplements for no reason. Everything has a very specific purpose that I've consulted with my doctor about as well. So another one that I'll take is just a probiotic, and then I will swallow that down with just a bunch of nice, cool water. And now we've gotten to the point where we finished all of our supplements. And another tip that I like to do just focus on taking one at a time in succession with the nice gulps of water as I go. So now that we finished all of our supplements, we finished our skincare, we finished our dental health, we're just going to go to the bathroom for one last time. And once we've done that, we're going to go upstairs or go to wherever your room is. And again, we're turning off any remaining lights that are time to get into total rest mode. So what I'll do, and this is something that you could consider too, is before getting into bed, I will just make sure that all of my pillows are there and my night guard is there and my mouth tape is there. My basal thermometer is there for charting my cycle and all my blankets are ready. And I will actually take some time sort of make my bed so that everything is in its exact right place, because I typically will sleep on my back for most of the night, and so I need everything that I need for support to be in the exact right place. I'll also take this moment to start up my heating pad so that when I get into bed, it's a little bit cozier. And so while that's happening, while the heating pad is now going, I'll also take a few minutes to just sit on the floor on a cushy, thick gymnastics mat, or even in my room, we actually have enough floor space on the carpet to actually have kind of a weird yet a very helpful setup where we have a camping Therm-a-Rest inflatable little camping mattress. It's really just meant for to go under a sleeping bag in a tent, but that's on the floor, and then on top of that is like a 3-inch thick memory foam topper. So that just provides the basis for me to do my stretching. So I'll sit on that or kneel on that, and I'll just do some slow, gentle breathing and stretches. And during this time, I might listen to a podcast or put on a show that is just relaxing and fun and something that I don't need to pay too much attention to. You want to make sure that whatever you're listening to is on a sleep timer so that it'll turn itself off automatically, usually around 45 minutes to only 1 hour. And you don't really want something to be playing all night long, because that can kind of be distracting and can actually kind of keep you awake or wake you up overnight. So it's best to listen to something as you fall asleep, but then for it to turn off afterwards so it's not waking you up or anything like that. This is especially true for screens or TVs or watching something on your phone, like even this video. So I want you to either turn your phone so it's face down and you can't see the light, or set the sleep timer on the show you're watching so that it'll turn off eventually. And after I've done some stretches and deep breathing, at this point I will finally lay down in my blankets with my heating pad, which is also on a timer, to automatically shut off after about an hour. And I'll just take my time in getting everything super comfortable. And as someone with a disability myself, I know how tough that can be. But this is why it's so important to really think proactively about all the pillows and supports that you might need to help to optimize your sleep. So take your time with this step and get as comfortable as possible. Even if it means you get into a position where you think it's comfortable and then you need to adjust a little bit later on, I want you to just fully take your time with this process until you start to feel nice and sleepy. Now this is the part where I kind of have what I think is a pretty obvious secret to help me to fall asleep. It's kind of a really obvious trick that I use that works every time. What I'll do is I'll get as comfortable as possible. Again, even if it takes me a few minutes to get comfortable. And once I am, and once I've set my sleep timers and I've got everything just focus on breathing in for 3 seconds and out for 3 seconds, or a count of three. And I want you to start by just repeating 1, 2, 3 for in, and then 1, 2, 3 for out. And you'll find after a few minutes of breathing in and out and counting to three with each in and out, that you'll actually be able to move it up to a count of four. 1, 2, 3, 4. Does not need to be 4 seconds exactly. We're just trying to generally slow down the breathing a little tiny bit. Where you breathe in for a count, you hold just for a second, and then you breathe back out for a count, and just repeat. When some people do box breathing, they'll even hold for the same count as they breathe in and out, but I like to keep it super simple, even simpler than that, just simply breathing in and out. And you're doing this without expectation and without any self-judgment. So there isn't really even the expectation that this will work, and there's no self-judgment if it's feeling like it's not working. But I want you to just keep going in for 3 seconds. Out for 3 seconds, and then in for maybe a count of four or three, and out for a count of three or four. We're just breathing in and out, and as you breathe in and out for probably will have thoughts coming up and going away, and new thoughts coming up. And I want you to try and just refocus on counting to 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And just focus on counting to four again and again. As you do this, you can connect more with your body by also, perhaps if it's comfortable for you, placing one hand on your belly and one hand on your chest. And as you breathe in, you want your belly hand to be forced to rise up sooner than your chest hand, because you're filling your belly with air first. And then your chest will follow. So by just gently touching your belly and your chest, engaging with your body and connecting with your body. This will help you to breathe deeper, and this will help you to stay in touch with the counting of four. Now for me, what I'll usually notice before I've consciously gotten sleepy is I'll notice around this time a little twitch of my feet, which indicates that sleep is going to come soon as long as I keep doing what I'm doing. You may need to yawn at some point. You may need to slow down your breathing even further, but I just want it to feel natural. At first, you may need to sort of intentionally slow down your breathing, but eventually, after maybe a minute or two, it should become Spinning.